We can filter remote connection from the previously collected events by analyzing log 4624. To filter out the several logons different from the ones related to remote connection, we can add the logon type equal to 10 parameter to our query. Let's assume we want to track all the remote connections established in November 2017. We get 8 results, for a total of 4 connections. Note that each entry has a duplicate with the same date and time. We can get other useful information by adding the parameters target logon ID and IP address corresponding respectively to the session's ID and to the IP of the machine that remotely connected. Note that all the connection has been requested by a host with IP 192.168.1.145. To find out the duration of a session, we can correlate the logon ID events 4624, an account was successfully logged on, and 4634, an account was logged off, and 4647, user initiated logoff, creating a specific query. First, let's see the structure of the data stored by log 4647. Okay, we get four fields: target user seed, target username, target domain name, target logon ID. As you can see, logon type is not stored in log 4647, so in this case we omit the parameter logon type equal to 10. We can create a query on the model of the previous one. We can do the same for log 4634. In this case, we get 5 fields: target user seed, target username, target domain name, target logon ID, logon type. Then we create our query. We can use the output CSV option to make a report. We can import the 3 CSV files obtained into an Excel workbook, 1 CSV file per sheet, and obtain a result like this. If we put our results in a single sheet, we can manage them better. Using target logon ID as a filter, we can see the beginning and the end of each remote connection. For example, the connection with ID 0x1ccdecd8 was started by user Mr. Red on the 13th of November 2017 at 22:33:45 and terminated at 22:34:20 according to events 4624 and 4634. If we want to keep track of connections within a Windows network, we should look for the 4768 event, the first generated on the domain controller when a user successfully authenticates and a ticket granting ticket is given. We can use the following query to extract only the information useful to our analysis. The result will be a chronologically ordered list of all users who have requested access to our domains, including seed and IP addresses.